This is Brian, and I am Jovita Lopez presenting the Sports Rainbow. With this weather that we have, alternating between sun and rain, and sometimes thunder showers, there's a lot of fever around the whole place. Cases of dengue fever, malaria, and so on and so forth. Delhi has been the worst hit with this dengue fever. But we have another fever that is developing in Goa, and that is ISL fever. ISL fever is an Indian Super League, and that's football. And when you talk of ISL, people are watching. People have been asking me, what about the tickets? Will we get them the tickets? Because you had house full people watching all the matches of the one and only Goan team that surprised everybody last year in the first edition. They went on to the semi-finals. And I'm sure that this year, people are hoping that they would be featuring in the finals. And the finals are slated to be played at the Nehru Stadium, Fathoda, on 20th of December. It's fortunate for us that despite being a holiday all over Goa, we could manage to have the owner or the co-owner of the FC Goa. And we welcome Mr. Srinivas Dempo, whom I have the privilege of calling him as Baba. Welcome, Baba, and nice to have you. Despite being a holiday, you have made it possible to be here. You have three matches, one after the other, on 4th of October, on 7th of October, and 11th of October, and two Sundays. And I'm sure that people are already making plans how to pack the stadium, and most importantly, to see a victory for FC Goa. What are your plans and your preparations this season?
I think, you know, first of all, it's great news for us that the Goans have really liked this team. It is primarily their team. We just happen to be just the promoters of the, you know, Mr. Salgaonkar, myself and Mr. Dood, and of course Virat Kohli, just happen to be promoters of this team. Primarily, it's a team that the Goans own, they love it, and there's a lot of passion behind it. Last year was more of a trial because it was the first year. We did see that we made a lot of mistakes. You always learn from your mistakes. So in terms of preparations, I personally feel that we are much better prepared this year because we had the time. We also saw the kind of response. As you said, people say that, you know, they want more and more tickets, but we have a limited capacity stadium. So we need to find out ways where there is as much as a fair distribution of tickets as possible.
Talking about the tickets, people have this notion that you announce the sale. Of course, you don't do that now, it's given. And you do it online and all that. You announce the sale of the tickets in a half an hour's time. The tickets are not available.
I'll just explain you what we did, what we are planning to do this year. A is we are going to have season tickets. So people will have an opportunity to buy the entire season tickets. B is we are opening the sale of tickets much in advance. I think the date that we are looking at is somewhere between 22nd to 23rd. So it's much more in advance. We are going to have much more physical locations this year. I think if I'm not mistaken, the marketing team has planned that almost 60% of the tickets are to be sold in physical locations. Only 40% will be sold online. So I think we want more and more Goans to come and watch. We want more and more Goans from different parts of Goa to come and watch. So we will try to reach to the Goans as much as possible physical locations. But yes, last year was a trial. We did learn from what we could do better. And this year we hope to do that in a much better way.
Yeah, you are talking about your preparations. Your team now is in Dubai. Three matches already held. Excellent results, I must say. Yeah, there's one victory against Al Shadab. And quite a strong team, former champions in Dubai. And two draws, 2-2 and 1-1, and two more to go. Are you happy with the results?
Yeah, I did. Apart from learning from the press, I did manage to watch one game. Myself and Mr. Salgaonkar, we both went and met the team and, you know.
So you were in Dubai?
Yes, we did go to Dubai. We spent a whole day with the team. We saw their practice, we saw their warm-up sessions. We met Zico and we met his entire support staff. I must tell you, the mood is jubilant. The team is vibing well, they're all together, you know, the warm-up sessions and the practice sessions have been brilliant. The match that we saw, it was a 2-2 draw, but it was a great match. The players look fit, and they all believe in the leadership of Zico. So I think Zico being there for us is one of the greatest strengths that FC Goa has. And with the kind of support, Jovito, which we had from the Goans in Dubai, it is unbelievable. I still have my hair standing when I talk about it. It is just brilliant. People came to us and they said, they thanked us and they said, you tell us what you want us to do for FC Goa here. We are all here for this team. And they have also promised, they were about, I was shocked and we didn't advertise nothing. It was just put on Facebook. There were almost about 400 Goans who came 2 hours by car to watch the game that we did. And they were crazy. They wanted pictures with the players. They were shouting to Zico to put in Romeo because Romeo was not there for the first 20 minutes. I just felt that I'm in Goa, you know,
yes,
for a moment.
Yes.
So just see the craze that has gone all over the world with Goans. And they have promised that if Goa reaches the finals, they will buy their own tickets and come and watch the game.
Oh my God.
So you can imagine the kind of love and support and, you know, the passion for this team.
And
their complaints were they are not getting jerseys, they want to buy. And, you know, we had carried a few of our last year's t-shirts, keychains. And they actually sat on the top of the stadium. They stood. And we, all the promoters and our staff and all, were throwing keychains, t-shirts, and they were grabbing them. I was shocked.
I'm sure you must have heard.
I mean,
too
it
much,
is just such a great feeling to see how much response this team has given and how people think, you know, that this is like Goa. And I still remember, I haven't seen Goans come together like this in a long time. I think probably during the language agitation. Okay, probably during my father's time when, you know, Goa was supposed to become merging with Maharashtra and all the Goans came together. And I think the third situation is FC Goa. You see, all Goans vying for one team.
Yes.
All Goans are so passionate about this team.
Because when you talk of FC Goa,
it's just
Goa. It's Goa.
Completely, I mean.
And you've got a beautiful symbol of the Goa that you have, so, our own.
So this is our, I think, if you ask me one single achievement that FC Goa has achieved, is that they have been owned and, you know, completely managed and owned by the people of Goa. I think that is something that is our greatest feeling. You know, losing, winning, whether you'll reach the finals, whether you'll win, is all part of the game. But something which will remain permanent, I want people of Goa 50 years down the line to say that FC Goa belongs to them. That is the
most
important.
Don't you think FC Goa is the unifying factor now?
Absolutely. That's why I said, I gave you three occasions in Goa where the whole of Goa unified, irrespective of your backgrounds, you know, your religion, your language. Everybody came to Goa for Konkani, for Goa as a separate identity, and for FC Goa. That is the biggest.
You had Houseful Stadium last year. And people were complaining that you reduced from 30 odd seats to 28 now. The position will be the same, or?
See, the issue is that, you know, we need to run this team, we need sponsorship. And to get sponsorship, we need to give certain freebies to the sponsor. You know, it's a part and parcel of every sponsorship deal which happens in any part of the football world. So a couple of thousand tickets go to the sponsors. A couple of thousand tickets go to the people who help us run this management, like ISL as a requirement. The stadium belongs to Sports Authority of Goa, so they get, you know, they are entitled to a few tickets. So with all this, there is so much that the capacity can be held. Of course, we have represented to ISL and they have said that they will release more number of tickets for sale this time than just keep with them. And people have been very, very sympathetic. Every authority that we talk to, we have been finding out ways. And Sandeep Jaks has been very, very helpful, the SAG director, as to how we can, within the constraints, increase the capacity of the stadium. So he's given a couple of suggestions as to, you know, how to dismantle the VIP section, you know, part of it, make more seats available, gives a few days. So we are trying our level best.
So that means this year we'll be able to accommodate a few more.
A few more, but I definitely would say that as much as we would like to accommodate, we can't. Ideal stadium of a size of between 35 and 40,000 would be the right capacity for Goa to have a houseful stadium and for as many Goans to enjoy the match as possible.
So you have the first three matches in Goa.
Yes.
Do you think it is an advantage for you?
I do believe any home match is an advantage for you. And if you are able to gather 9 points straight away, it will be challenging for the other teams.
It will be a head start for you.
Probably, you know, it's that psychological.
Yes, yes.
And I think it's a great thing. And out of the three, two are Sundays.
Yes.
So you are even, you know, you expect even a more crowd to come and enjoy the match. And
people are already looking for the tickets, let me tell you. And they say, we were unhappy last year that we were there, but we couldn't get into the stadium.
So through your TV channel medium, I'd like to tell all our Goan brothers and sisters that A is we are starting ticket sales much more in advance. B is we are going to have season tickets, as I said, I'm just repeating. Third is we are going to have many more physical locations than last year. Last year we had just two physical locations, one in Pandyam and one in Fatehgarh Stadium.
I'm sure they'll be exhausted in a matter of few hours.
We are also trying to take help of GFA, whether you know we can keep a few tickets in Dulher Stadium, a few in Margaon. So you know, as many locations as possible.
But I would differ with you. You don't even have to keep at these different locations. You think of ISL and think of FC Goa.
Yes. No, we just want people to be less inconvenienced.
Okay.
So, you know,
that's
at
nice.
Least the major,
nice.
At least Mapsa, Margaon, Panji, Vasco, as many locations. I mean, maybe one location in each of these major.
That's a nice thought of you.
And also saying that more than 50% will be now physical. Instead of earlier, the online were much more. So we've said that, of course, we also need to give online. Where there are people who love sitting in the comfort of their home and booking. So it's going to be a combination of online and physical, but physical will be more than the online this year.
And about your players now, you have a marquee player, Luciano Sabroso, and what the other Brazilians, and then you have got the Goans. Are they mixing?
As I said in my initial statement, the vibe that I got is they are really vibing well. They mix well. They look very fit. Compared to last year, I think our team is two times more fitter. And the advantage we have is we have Zico from day one this time.
Yeah, last year we started
so
a pretty late.
We started a little late, you remember that he came in.
But then we made up.
Yeah, we did make up, but you know, we had that initial disadvantage that Zico came in a little late and you know, then for the time to get set, each coach, and I'm not saying one coach is wrong and one coach is right, each coach has his unique style and you know football.
Yes, yes.
So it took some time for the team to settle. From today, the team looks settled from day one. And this going to Dubai, I mean the infrastructure that they've set up, hats off to that.
What did you find different in
amazing
stadium in Dubai?
Where we practice, they have 7 or 8 grounds in that same complex. Different grounds, the gym is state of the art. You know what? They have everything. I mean, sometimes you wonder that if our country and our state is really serious about sports, that's the kind of infrastructure that we need to think of. And we need to make it self-paying.
Yes.
We can't have white elephants. That we all should realize that when a government invests in anything, it has to be constantly paying back to keep that facility intact. But this was a world-class facility. And that's why I'm saying that they are scoring over us. They are much more fitter. They are much more, you know, even a country like UAE, if you look at their football players, only because of the facilities that they have.
So they have much better infrastructure.
Their nutrition, their infrastructure. You know, their grounds, their training, everything counts in terms of, you know, how a fit.
How in a scale of 10, how would you rate a Dubai stadium and the Nehru stadium?
There is no comparison. I mean, I would say Dubai is, I mean, the Nehru stadium, Fatehgarh, is one of the best stadiums in the country. By
yes, it is.
We
it
must
is.
Give adequate acknowledgement to the government of Goa for keeping, and I must salute Mr. Parikar's vision for making Goa as the football official state. Having said that, if you tell me to compare, I mean, Dubai may be 9.5 out of 10 and we may be 5, if you are strictly talking about relative comparison. They have invested and pumped in a lot of money. Actually, the hotel that we were staying, the Maidan Hotel, is a race course hotel. They are thinking of putting 2 football stadiums inside the hotel.
Is it?
They have such a huge area, the Maidan Hotel, where all our players and we were staying. You can imagine how serious about they are about developing football.
Do you think that such seriousness can come into us in India, if not Goa?
I think sure. I mean, you know, if you look at the kind of athletes that have been winning medals in the Olympics, there are various NGOs such as the Olympic Gold Quest, various private sector players who are doing, for example, in our own small state, Dempos have been trying to inculcate and help a few athletes. And I think if everybody comes forward, it should be a sort of a tri-sector partnership with the government, the private sector and the people of Goa to say that if we need the best football team in the country or the best football team internationally, we are all going to devote our time, resources and energy to making. And that's where, you know, Jovito, things like grassroots football development have to be taken more seriously. And I am always an optimist. I am hopeful that in the next 5 years, if we can get more than 50% of the Goan boys in ISL team in Goa, that will be the biggest achievement that we'll get.
You have practically two teams in Goa. As your umpire, Dempo, you have got the Dempo Sports Club, and then you have got FC Goa. What is the difference now between these two teams?
I'll tell you how I've been working. Of course, my first love is always Dempo, because, you know, I've been going as a kid for the games. You used to be there, you know, and watch. But there is, you know, Dempo Sports Club has a role and ISL has a role and FC Goa has a role. Apparently, AIFF is also now talking about integrating the two leagues. Be it that is, at some stage, it will be only one league. And I think if there's one league, then it makes sense for FC Goa to continue in that
league. So we are talking about two leagues.
Yes.
I think we can have a big discussion whether the two leagues will continue or not.
Sure.
So we'll have a small break and stay back with us. We'll come with lots more about the two leagues and the professionalism in football in India and Goa. Welcome back. You are watching the Sports Rainbow, and we have with us Mr. Srinivas Dempo, whom we affectionately call as Baba. He has a dual role in football at the national level. He is the vice president of the All India Football Federation, and he has got two teams, one in the I League, the Dempo Sports Club, and in the ISL, he has the team called FC Goa. How do you manage, Baba, to have both the teams and run them well?
See, first of all, we have to admit to one fact that, you know, the I-League is the main league of the country. It's the core league, which is recognized by FIFA. ISL was just given a window to, you know, market a league, a shorter term league, which makes football more popular. And I think it has done that very well. Having said this, it is now time that every stakeholder in football realizes that it's very difficult to run two leagues. And you yourself have admitted that the ISL is marketed very well. Somehow it has caught the fancy of people, young, old, new, serious football players, entertainers, everybody it has caught. And I-League is slowly losing its attendance and charm, although that was supposed to be the more serious league. So all stakeholders in football are supposed to sit together and see how we integrate the two leagues. Having said that, I think one has to recognize the fact that any football league doesn't come at a low cost. We need to focus on investment in football. We need to focus on how we will upgrade the grassroots development programs. And we need to not forget history. Legacy is very important. There are families like the Mohanbagan, East Bengal, Mohammedan Sporting, Dempo, Salgaonkar, I mean, who have operated for more than 40 years today. And then subsequently, there were other entrepreneurs, like Sporting Club, Churchill, you know, so many who came back. And I think you must compliment them for the brilliant job they've done to protect and upgrade Indian football. So with this sentiment in mind, if some solution could be found out as to how we integrate the I-League, that is the promoters of the I-League football, into the ISL, or whatever, integrating ISL into I-League and making it one league. Because I'll tell you, we will have players for a longer duration. Today, good players complain to us, what can we do 3 months
and
then go back? Sponsors are also complaining. They say your visibility is only for 3 months. When we spend so much of money, we need a longer term visibility. So if you factor all that in, I think the commercial viability of one league is far higher than making two or three leagues.
You have two teams, and therefore your investment will be much, much higher. How do you manage now to overcome the deficit that you are running?
So as I said a little earlier, you know, if we accept the fact that in some eventuality you'll have one league, then it makes much more sense for that league to be continued, you know, the FC Goa team to be playing in that league. Simply because FC Goa is one unified team for all the Goans. And I think Goans have caught the fancy of that. And then subsequently what we could do is develop Dempos as a strong grassroots development program. So with all this in mind, we have a Dempo team which produces the best of players. We have a strong, serious grassroots program. And then follow it up with, you know, providing players to the Indian football system. I think this brilliant combination will work very well.
Now, last year you have had ISL. Was it a winning proposition from you from the point of view of money? Well, you spend in crores, I'm sure.
Yeah, it was not, because it's not easy to make football money in football in any part of the world in 1 or 2 years. You need to have that sustained league. You need to have at least a long-term vision of 3 to 5 years to make sure that commercial viability will come into FC Goa.
Because even when you had the team in the I League, they said about 15 to 20 crores was the annual budget.
I completely
and
agree.
And for ISL, it
is even much more.
Much more.
That's why I said that football requires investment in a much larger number.
How long do you think you can break even?
My gut feel is that we need to run it anywhere between 3 to 5 years to break even. And then we look into a long-term commercial viability for that team.
I know you have inducted Cats Naidu for your grassroots program or the project. And you are going to have, I was told, the girls team also. So what is your grassroots and youth development program?
So this all comes out of passion for football. And it all comes out of a belief that Goa has a long history in football. We need to keep that history going. We need to produce good footballers. And Goa has to start at a very young age. You know, an average footballer to start with should be between 7 to 8 years old. And that's the reason I appointed Cats Naidu. I found him to be operating very well in his erstwhile job with GFDC. Very serious guy, very committed, you know. And then we said that why only boys, why not girls? Because you remember many years back, Goan football team,
yes,
during the times of Yolanda and, you know,
Rekha
and all these were doing wonderful job. So we said that girls also should be given an equal opportunity. And that's why next year we want to start a girls team. This year we've started with the boys in all the 8 sectors. And I think we've made a good beginning. Now it's for us to see how far we proceed. And my vision should be that they should be world-class football players to go into any league and play.
So that means you will have to look into the physical aspect, you will have to look into the nutritional aspect.
And infrastructure.
Will you take care
Absolutely.
Of all this?
So that's where the investment will go as far as Dempo Sports Club is concerned. Nutrition, infrastructure and good training. I think these are the 3 things where you'll need capital investment to go.
And you have adopted also some schools for your youth development
Sure.
program. How's that progressing?
Yeah, so we'll have a 2 concept. One is we'll have satellite clubs in every village that we plan to adopt and then make the sport popular. And secondly is the school program. The school program is now redesigned by CATS to see that it's, you know, falling in line with our underage youth development program. So this is an integration of the whole thing, that schools, villages and our own underage youth team should fall in place so that football progresses.
So you have developed a new philosophy for the football development.
Absolutely. So we need to revive this, and we need to say that if you want a low cost model, ultimately you'll need to produce.
And you don't mind pumping in more money?
For this, no. I mean, this is a money I think which is well spent. That ultimately youth development will give you low cost players, and those players will then save money for you in the long run.
And about infrastructure, I know you had plans to have your own stadium. Where you have?
We still have a plan. We've got an approval from the government of Goa to set up a school with a football academy in somewhere near 10 to 12 kilometers away from Panji, where the company owns land. And we are in full process to see how we can now start implementing the course. All going well, if we have all the investment in line, then by 2017 we should come up with our own football ground and academy.
And the stadium will accommodate how many?
The stadium will be not very large. The more thing is to produce players to play in bigger tournaments. So we'll have a great state-of-the-art football pitch. We'll have a good football academy with a hostel, conference facilities,
so in-house.
State-of-the-art gym, okay. So that we produce young footballers and then...
And now that we have seen the best in Dubai, I'm sure you'll want
sure,
to have
Sure, we can evaluate model. Some of the practices.
Yes. And what are your future plans?
Our future plans is to build FC Goa into a big brand, which will be loved and respected and, you know, cared for by the Goans. And of course, the Dempo Sports Club to be a budding youth team. They would
so
like
there will be the supply line.
And they will produce some of the best Goan football players to, you know, play in any international tournament.
Last year you had Virat Kohli and the other actors with you. Are they also this year?
Sure, they're all there as co-promoters and co-owners.
So you'll have Virat Kohli coming?
We will have Kohli coming and many of our other brand ambassadors like Varun Dhawan.
Both of them are.
Yeah,
they are
very much a part of it.
Okay, and your matches now that you are going to have, will you have also some merchandising?
We will have merchandising better than last year. Although we are still discussing with Adidas, because Adidas are our official merchandise.
Okay, do you think your fans will buy the merchandise?
I'm sure
because
they will.
Normally in Goa, the trend is Phukot, you know?
No, I think it's changing now. People complained last year that we want official merchandise and we are not getting it.
Okay. So you are changing the trend?
Yeah.
You'll be a trendsetter.
We or rather Goans are changing the trend.
Okay, that's good. And any message for the football fans?
I'm just appealing to all the football loving fans of Goa that do continue to support FC Goa. It is because of their support and love that this has become a strong brand. And they should always own this team, saying that it is their team, and I think the success then will be for all the Goans to see.
What is surprising, Baba, is that you are pumping in so much money and commercially you don't even get benefits because you don't have a product that you sell under the brand name of Dempol. Still you are doing it for football.
I think, you know, the two families have operated in football for a very long time. It's somewhere the passion is still continuing.
I remember your grandfather.
Somewhere down the line, I think it is for the Goans. And if the brand is successful tomorrow, yes, commercial viability will be proven and we'll still continue to invest in the game.
I remember your grandfather
in the same place. Yes.
And he talked the same thing what you are now talking.
So it's Vasan love for the game.
Vasan Bab. Then also I had a privilege of meeting your father, Nagesh Bab, here at the same place.
So.
And now I am the third generation. And all three of them are talking the same language.
So we all believe that, you know, Goans and football are inseparable. And we all have a duty. If we've made all our profits in this state of Goa, it's our duty, it's our corporate responsibility that we, you know, at least give back to Goa in terms of giving world-class football.
Baba, I salute you for your wonderful
vision for
football. And I'm sure that all the fans will be looking for first, the tickets, and I hope more and more of
hopefully
them.
Hopefully, they should be more satisfied.
Yeah, they will be there. And
thank you so much for having your
valuable time on a holiday.
Thanks.
And it was nice. I'm sure you'll have more people rooting for FC Goa. And I'm sure that all our wishes is that to see on 20th December FC Goa in the finals and winning the trophy. That will be the glorious moment for all of us. Keep on watching Sports Rainbow. We'll give you the updates and feel free that you are going to get the tickets. This is Prime and I'm Jovita Lopish signing off.